guys. Hello. Well, here they are. A rather belated 6-week vlog. Whoops. Sorry we're on the drag with this, but we've had an incredibly busy week. And there's no excuse. Well, there probably is an excuse, actually. Our other bitch, Jersey, whelped earlier in the week. And then to crown it all, and Harriet, my eldest daughter, bless her. It's not that I wasn't ungrateful for a second grandchild, but she gave birth on Tuesday. So congratulations, Harriet and James, with your lovely little Ella. But we've been looking after Henny for a couple of days, her 1-year-old, and 2 litters of German pointers, a 1.5-year-old, and a daughter that's just whelped herself was quite a lot to fit in one way and another. But hey, these guys have taken up a lot of time and we've loved it. Oopsie daisy, there, big noise. They're coming on fantastically. It was great to see some people at the weekend viewing their pup for the first time. Not everybody's been able to do that, but of course you've had the videos which don't replace hands-on, I know, but we've got somebody under here. You know, it's the next best thing, and I appreciate, you know, time to travel on perhaps a 5 or 6 hour round trip is really, when it's being done in 10 days time, is probably a lot. So yeah, they're all, ooh, this is what's gonna happen in your kitchen. Anything and everything, I'm afraid, gets trashed. I know it's times 7 what you'll experience, but it's pretty full on. Hello. Yes. They're ever so outgoing. There's lots of noises in here during the day, stable doors crashing and bashing and people in and out. And they watch that from their stable and hear it all. And then probably 3 times a day, they're coming out in here and having a rip-roaring time. You'll recognize your puppies now because of course you all know who's who and who you're having. There's a few names even. This is Purdy on the right, her back view. Hello. I can't remember what your name's going to be. I don't think actually you have a name yet. These two little guys are actually going together, which is rather nice because it wasn't an accident. They've buddied up. They're fantastic friends here. And although they'll be trained quite separately, they're going to be living together. So that was rather nice and lovely for them. This big boy here, he's Rigby. And he's a very smart chap, aren't you? Hey? And anyway, they're all still, you know, doing lots of growing, lots of eating. Decent meals a day, and they're hungry when the meal is presented to them, you know. Hang on, I'm being attacked here. Hello. But they're such robust puppies. Dora's been able to do this each time, and it is the most wonderful thing from a breeder's point of view to have such strong, vigorous pups that just attack life. So get prepared. There. They'll probably go back a peg when they get on their own because they're, yes, that's a scary thing, isn't it? She's usually such a brave one. I don't know what she's reading there. She says there's something. There's something there she's not sure about. How funny. That dish was used at lunchtime for something and was washed out. Perhaps it's still got a bit of a smell about it because the older dogs have a bit of tripe, and maybe that's what it was. Yes, that was a bit of something, wasn't it? But yeah, here they are. So I'll let you just watch them for a moment. We've got Jersey's brood next door, just a few days old, and she's peered at these in horror, actually. Poor dog, you know, it'd be interesting to know how much they understand, wouldn't it? Probably a lot more than we give them credit for. But they're such nosy parkers, they really are. And then sometimes they'll scare themselves and stop dead and drop their tails, and then they just charge into it. It's So I don't know what that few moments grace just to read it again, and then they just go. Very sharp little teeth. Oh yes, such loving puppies. And I love the way when you pick them up, they just generally go into a zone and flop and are really quiet and sort of loving, which is really nice because you don't want to pick up a sort of velociraptor. This is a great floor actually for their little feet, because obviously just on the concrete, I think it helps to sort of keep their feet in good shape and keep their nails nice and short. I have trimmed all their nails, but I'd advise you all to do that quite regularly when they're tiny. I lapsed with Carrot, and she was really naughty when I came to do it again. And she'd been fine at the beginning, but she, because her nails and her feet were so good, I haven't bothered to do it. So it's worth going through the motions, and it's about getting hold of their feet as much as it is about cutting their nails. You know, they don't like you to sort of get their foot and inspect it. Okay, so there you are. I think you've had a good look at them all. It'd be handy if they all got on that mat and played, but of course they won't do that. Oh, here goes another one. And who's this? This is little Purdy down here. Look, you've got to get in front of the camera. Go on, off you go. Go on, off you go. Oh, she says, I don't want to. I want to come and see you and be a nuisance. Go on, off you go. Off you go. Off you go. Go on, go on. Go on. No, he's not having any of it. Okay, well, we'll just get them bigger and more playful in the next 10 days, I'm afraid. But they're great to have around. Really lovely. We're enjoying it. Hope you are too.